Alright folks, in this video you're going to see what happens when my son Grayson gets his chance at the first buck of 2017. Alright folks, like I told you, these hunting videos are not going to be like the regular hunting videos you see on TV. TV shows with the big bucks and the names and all that. As a matter of fact, we didn't even get any video of this deer. If this was a real hunting show, this deer would have never been shot, because in real hunting shows, they don't roll until, or they don't shoot until they've got a deer in sight and on camera. We're just some old country boys that want to go hunting and shoot a deer, and this happened quickly, and as you're going to see, there was no time to get a camera out.
So what happened was, we got out there, and we got out there a little bit late, and there was a buck sitting out there, and my dad was already in the middle of the road, saw it, so then he had to scoot up, he had to get out of the road where the buck couldn't see him. He looked back, I'm 100 yards away. I started to walk faster to get over there. So then I got over there, he said, son, there's a buck. And then he kept saying, can you see it, can you see it? And I couldn't see it through the scope. So then we keep scooting over, I'm on my knees and everything. Got shooting sticks and the muzzleloader. Scooting over and scooting over. And then I said, I can see it. And he said, can you see the neck? I said, no, just a little bit. He said, is it enough to shoot? I said, nope. So then a deer about runs off. My dad goes, meh, meh, meh. And then it finally stopped. So then daddy said, my dad said, shoot now, shoot, you have to shoot. And then I shot the deer.
All right, guys, we just got in the woods, and we honestly, actually, if you look right back up through there, you see smoke. It's because Grayson took a shot. We were literally walking in to this food plot, and Grayson, being slow like he normally is, was lagging behind me. I get up and look, and I see a deer standing in the food plot, and I couldn't tell if it was a buck or not. We got down, and I got the binoculars out, got the primer in the gun, and looked up. Still there. I'm surprised the deer stayed there. I got the binoculars out and looked, and it had horns on it. So we fiddled around with Grayson, crawling around, trying to see the deer, trying to get it into scope. Finally got it.
Then it ran.
It took off.
Right here. It ran about to over there, and then it about ran off into the woods, and my dad went meh, meh, and then I took a shot.
Took a shot about 120 yards, and as a matter of fact, you can still see the smoke off the black powder coming down through there. And we got out here, and we seen where it kicked up and took off running. We got over here, and Grayson was the first one to see it. But there's blood.
It's
pretty good looking blood trail. So we're gonna. When he took off tail down. Not totally hunkered, but he was looking down. You can see that's blood splatter right there. You can tell the deer was moving. Blood hit, splattered that way.
There's more of it.
Alright, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to be smart for a second.
There's a trail over
yeah.
Here.
It is. It's 7:15. Now we shot that deer with the black powder, 50 caliber. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna wait a minute. We're just gonna wait and go get our crap together up here. Let it get a little more light, because it's still sun's just sunrise now, so we're gonna give it a minute. You good with that? At least we got blood. We know he went in right here.
I see the trail right there.
Yeah.
Trail, so.
And we're gonna give it a minute, just to, that way we don't bump this deer up in case he's not hit really good. But looks like some good blood off of it so far, so we're just gonna give him a little bit. Just, good job, pal.
Just give him a minute in peace.
This is just being smart here. Looks like a good hit on it. We got good blood, but I just as soon sit and wait 30 minutes just to let him let him get in there and rest and not get pushed, just in case it's a, looks like he's spewing blood, but I always like to err on the side of caution. We're hunting nothing but a pine thicket right here. You can see we got a food plot. It's just come up, so it's thick in there, and don't want to bump him up, so we're going to try to sit down and relax up here as hard as that may be. All right, folks, we slipped back here into the blind. We're set up watching this plot, looking at some trail cam pictures on the phone. We're just going to wait. It's a lot easier for me to say wait when it's his deer than it is for me to do it when it's my deer. Guys, what I like to do is I use a paper towel or some toilet paper, use that to mark the trail. Kind of see there where it's at. Pretty good blood splatter all around through here. He's going straight back that way. See if we can find him. There's our opening. There's something right there on that grass that's real good. That's a good splatter. So we know he went in. There's more of it there. So what I'll do is, hold that for a second, son. I'll put a piece, just a little piece right here. Just tomorrow. Where he went into the woods at. That just helps us keep track of which way he's going. Now generally, my blood trailing technique is not to go too far without seeing blood right there, son. And generally speaking, these deer are gonna run a trail or an easy route into the woods. Some good blood right there, guys. What we're doing, this is a good lesson for Grayson on blood trailing a deer. You try not to go too far without finding blood once you're on the trail, because you can really stomp a bunch of good blood sign down. Like I said, I'm using the paper towels just to mark it every time I find it. So you can tell it's pretty thick out here. That's where he was heading, into the thick stuff. All right, folks, where have we seen this before? Where have we seen that before? Look at there.
Oh my goodness gracious.
Got blood all up in here on this beauty berry. The thing I like about this is he's starting to crash into stuff, which is more optimistic. And as I said, we're going just finding some blood, making a move. Finding the blood, making some move.
We found the blood trail, and then we blood trailed it for 45 minutes, and then the deer was laying down. And then it got up, and we don't know if it was the same deer. It probably was, cause there was blood where it was laying. So it ran off, and then we kept finding the trail, and then the blood trail just stopped out of nowhere. We got up to a white rock, and then that's when we stopped looking.
All right, guys, we took a break, went and grabbed some lunch. Back in the woods looking again. We brought a couple guys from hunt camp with us. Looking around, we decided to give it a couple hours. So came to the last blood, and see if we can find him. It is thick in here, as you can tell. Blood gets a little bit harder to see once it gets dried up in the middle of the day.
When we couldn't find it, my whole face was wet with tears, because it would have been my biggest deer yet. And me and my dad can't stop thinking. We keep replaying what happened in our mind. Like, we're just thinking and thinking and thinking. And every time I think about that deer, I always cry. The thing I enjoyed the most was being with my dad, being with everybody, and seeing all the deer we saw, which was really cool. And that's my deer tale, and I'm sticking to it.